And if we want to experience more of the forest than we do in the usual way, then we definitely also have to experience it at night. After all, about half of any 24-hour period is the nighttime, and hence, half of any forest's life is spent in darkness. We hardly ever think of them this way, but the trees are still here after the sun goes down. There are the same swaying branches, the same rustling leaves, but when you look, and for us that usually means having to use an artificial light, then you can immediately see that the inhabitants are different. Of course, inhabitants is not really the right word. These animals inhabit a forest 24 hours a day. It is just that they hide and scarcely move when the light is out. So, just like in a human city, it is a matter of a day shift of workers being replaced by the night shift. I can see a few moths and bats flying in and out of my beam of artificial light, but that is, in its way, just what it sounds like. Artificial. If we really want to experience the forest in the most natural way possible, or at least in a way that may more closely resemble what these creatures experience, then we will do well to turn off our artificial lights. For the benefit of this video, we have now switched over to using infrared light. So you can see me, but I can scarcely make out the moonlight filtering down through the leaves. Now, in order to navigate, I have to feel my way around. Indeed, many nocturnal animals do just that. And when we temporarily give up our eyesight in this way, it can be somewhat liberating. The forest is a wonderful place to touch, with rich sensations at our fingertips in every direction. It definitely allows one to explore and experience the complexity of a forest in a very different and somewhat primal way. There's also the sense of smell. The smell of the forest during the night and day seems similar at first, but when you tune everything else out and focus in on it, you can begin to pick up differences. They are subtle at first, almost subconscious, but when you really concentrate on it, you find that the nighttime does indeed bring with it new smells. These come both from flowers that bloom only at night, trying as they do to attract nocturnal pollinators, as well as from animals that are only active in the nighttime. Most of those animals are only communicating with each other by a class of chemicals called pheromones. It is a rich smorgasbord of smells. It is wave after wave of varying aromas that, in their own way, are just as wonderful to experience as the beautiful sights during the daytime. And of course, there are also sounds. And when you stop and pay attention, you realize that they are even louder and reflect an even greater diversity than those of the daytime. This is not surprising when you think about it. All nocturnal animals, insects included, have to rely more on sound for their signaling, since vision is of so little use under these circumstances. If you have not yet done so, then you should definitely give this a try. Arrange somehow to spend some time alone in a forest at night. Leave off your lights, remain perfectly still, and listen. You will hear the moaning of the swaying branches and the whispering of the rustling leaves. And all of that will be background to the music made by the countless insects and other animals. The sounds of the forest will envelop you, and the earth will be singing to you.